Psalms chapter 9, verse 10. And they that know thy name will put their trust in thee. For thou, O Yahweh El Shah, hast not forsaken them that seek thee. I give all prayers and honor and glory to Yahweh Shem El Shah, Ba'ashim Rechakurash, to Yahweh Shem El Shah, for giving us the apostles and the elders of great millstone who deserved of honors, rightfully so. Shalom to the Akim, pushing the word of sincerity and the truth, and being faith-based, and being prepared for what is to come. And what is to come? Race wars, famine, concentration camps, the RFID chip, which is the mark of the beast. 200 million missiles hitting the soils of America. Simultaneously, the chariots of the Lord lift up the whole four left into the chambers. Simultaneously, the chariots of the Lord shooting laser beams at the ungodly and the heathens. Rightfully so. Hey, Abarat, the side of the Lord, take the course of this video. I'm just a vessel seeking salvation. Hey, so why do y'all about Shem El Shah for our apostles and elders? Because if we're going through this ordeal, right? This fight, you know, all these things. Trust, believe, our brothers is going through it too, and which is very powerful and dynamic. Cause you know, I'm just rolling in the spirit, and when I turned this all right, so lock it. Let me say this. Time is 1:09 a.m. in the morning, October 18th, 2022, the year of the turnip, and I was, the brother said something, I didn't even watch maybe like 3 minutes in, and the name of his video, Shalom to my brother, you know, I'm gonna pull up his video, this is the name of his video, which is very powerful, because based upon what's happening right now, and our patience, I remember Apostle Ramlal said, he said, we look like we crazy, you know? We like we losing our mind. People will think we insane for the things that we want to see happen. You know, based upon this society. You know, oh, you got job, you got this, you got that, you got children. Why do you want the place to be destroyed? To the society, it look like we're crazy. But based upon the scriptures, which our faith in Yahweh El Shah is in these words, you know, that's what keeps us sane, that's what keeps us in a mental stabilization. I'll say it if I said that right, okay, because we are stabilized by these scriptures, you know, because this is what it says, by us trusting Yahweh El Shah, he has guided us. Alright? And his name is our foundation. Right? The name. Alright? The name. I'm just trying to think of the verse because it's coming to my mind. Salakia. Let's see something. I just want to try something real fast. I do believe it's the fear of the... No, I gotta... Let me see. Give me 1 second. I want to see something here. Because we are encountering something glorious, man. And it's gonna hurt people that don't want to accept it. That's where it's happening at. The people that don't want to accept it. And they... Because you know why? They're stuck in this world. This world... Hey, I just came back home. Maybe, it's yesterday morning. I'm traveling through coast to coast. You know, most of the ride I'm hungry. And what is the ultimate franchise I see the most? And I don't eat that shit. You know, McDonald's. I was saying that to some individuals, and that shit made me angry. You know, I was fucking angry. I was pissed off. You know, I was pissed off how much I see. And that's monopolizing. So whoever's in charge of that franchise, even though that's another cover up. Oh, you buy this one and you're in charge of this one. That's a cover up. So they got to pay whoever they bought the franchise from. That location from. They pay. It's somebody behind the scene getting a lot more money off these little bum ass, fake ass food. That's driving me insane. Okay? That drove me insane. I was losing my damn mind over that shit coming through from New York all the way to D.C. It drove me mad. I was kind of pissed off because I couldn't say anything. But I was speaking to an individual based upon, because I feel like the spirit of Yahba Shem El Shah wanted me to say something to this young man. I'm going to say, he was a young man. He was working with me. And I had to say it. I couldn't help it. I was compelled. Like I said, the Lord, it was something that was saying, no, talk to him. Say something to him. So I did it. And lo and behold, it resonated to his spirit. I don't know if he kept it. I don't know if he, because he was going through, I felt him going through what he was going through. You know, I felt his pain. And so, and then he explained what he was going through. Like, I didn't know, but he explained it. It's like, wow. He's insane. And I had to run down. I had to give him the quick, the quick rundown. Quick. I had to let him know fast because I didn't have that much time. The job was ended at 11. And they, if they wanted you to work a little longer, you work a little longer. But I was trying to get the hell out of there. So I let him know all the things he did wrong, whatever. What I said, you better do this or else you're going to fucking die here. That's what I told him. So, and he got kind of looking at me all nervous. But he needed that. And that's our job. And I told him that. I said, my job is to tell you what you're doing wrong. And you need to, this is what you need to fix. Because not based upon, like, me. Like, because I came out of this world, too. So it's not like, oh, I'm forgetting about myself. Why do you think I'm doing it? So the Lord can forgive. Why do you think we're doing it? So the Lord, Yahba Shemaiah, can forgive us. Okay? All right, so Salaki, I really, I'm just going off my situation that I experienced on a journey to perfection. This is a journey to perfection, bros. Akiam, this is a journey to perfection. All right, so I told the individual, I said, if you pray, the Lord will give you his answer. All right, so that's what that's what I was explaining. And the brother, the New York brother, the London brother, he put up a video, right? And I just watched this, just what he said, and then I didn't even get to watch the whole video. And this would let me to have this video right now, what I'm doing. So he said, the name of his video was "I'm Losing My Mind," and I tell you, I was laying down and I jumped up, and I'm laying down, clicking on my little mouse. I jumped up. I said, "What the hell?" And I understand what he was saying, because to the society, we are insane. What? Salaki, 1 second. Hey, Salapia. Hey, Shalom. So, I wanted to look up the word insane, right? To this world, we are insane, right? Right? It says right here.
Insane. Insane.
To this world, we are insane, man. Like, you know, the things we do, we out on the highway, we out on the highways and hedges, out there standing with a sheet on, right? That's what they're saying. Oh! You got a blanket on. What are you talking about? Go get a job. And us brothers, we work the hardest. You know? In this so-called right state of mind society, right? So this it just came to my mind. So the brother, he put the video up, and I was just like, he said, I heard the first part, and when he said, I listened to a little bit. I didn't get it, but it dropped me. It made me go get these verses. This verse right here. First, I'm gonna come back to this verse right here. Alright. Because what keeps us sane is Yahweh Yahushua. He stabilizes our mind by being in these scriptures. Right? And this verse came up first, so I just wanted to read it. I'm gonna read it again. Psalm chapter 9, verse 10. And they that know thy name, that right there is very important. The name of Yahweh Yahushua will put their trust in thee. And that's what we do. And this based upon my weekend I had, right? I had went to this job and I went across country. Like, to me, it was like more than 8 hours. It was give or take 5 hours to the job, but it took me 8 hours to get there because the drive trying to stay stabilized in the society is insane. To us, but it's saying what keeps us our sanity is the boy Yabashim El Shah, because when I went on this journey to go get this money, right, I had to get the shekels, right? I gotta pay bills. That's insane to try to keep up with this the society. This is insane. Okay, this is insane to try to go to work every fucking day out of your fucking way just to get some goddamn shekels. That's insane. But the name of Yahweh Yahushua is what's comforting us and what's keeping us stabilized. It's stabilizing us to go through this. You know? I didn't have any other verses, but this verse is only one I could. And it says, Psalms of the 9, verse 10. And they that know thy name will put their trust in thee. For thou, O Lord Yahweh Yahushua, has not forsaken them that seek thee. So when you seek Yahweh Yahushua, before I made this journey there, right? Before I took the job, I said, oh, wait, the job is way in D.C. I said, I know the Elder Monagon down there. This is the stabilization. I can still go do the work. I was more excited about going to do the work of Yahushua Yahushua, making sure I had the passage to get there to go do the will. So I set it up. Boom. I called the elders. And, oh, yeah, come on down, brother. Stabilize. Now I could do the work. Then I took the job. Boom. The job. Now I said, oh, good. Now I'm set up to go do the will of Yahushua Yahushua. And get my shekels. And this is troubling. I'm looking at this next verse that's in this. I think I'm gonna read all this. I'm gonna skip down to this verse here. Cause this verse is stuck out. Wow, that one too. Wow. All right. Let me see something here. Salakia. It says the name of this chapter is a psalm of thanksgiving for Yahweh justice. That just stuck out. So just, all right, let's get back. Oh, let's go up a verse. Wow, that's what I'm saying. Oh man. The Yahweh Shemel Shah for perfection. I'm telling you, man, righteousness is very important. Look at this. It said, listen, we're just going to read this. Okay, I'm going to go up a verse. It says, Psalms 9, verse 9. The Lord Yahweh El Shah also will be a refuge for the oppressed. We are oppressed. This is why the brother, when he said what he said, and it dawned on me. I said, wait a minute. We prisoners of hope. Let's go into the word refuge real fast. It said the Lord Yahweh Yahushua also will be a refuge for the oppressed and a refuge in a time of trouble. So, you know, right now we get to make our shekels. Hey, I never went cross country how I'm going nowadays, okay? And I feel the Lord's setting me up. He's preparing me to be a pilgrim, to be able to travel, navigate. You know? I don't know if I'll be able to do it. You know, only Abba Shemuel Shagun got us. And I truly believe he guided me down here to meet the brothers down in D.C. Because when the brothers saw me, they were excited. I was excited. The adrenaline is the same as I'm in New York. I was excited. So, yeah, we to the society...